They call themselves Bikers for Mandela, and every year they travel across the back roads of South Africa, stopping along the way to help people, to do good, inspired by Mandela's example. An initiative started by the former president's longtime personal assistant, Zelda Lekhansi, who spoke to us when the bikers stopped off in Kunu to wish Mandela happy birthday in July 2012.
We all love motorbiking, firstly, and secondly, we all love making a difference in other people's lives. It's committed, passionate people that's with me on the ride, and that's what it's all about.
Mandela's legacy has been honored in many ways by different people. On South Africa's banknotes, on t-shirts, even on salt and pepper shakers.
Legacy is not something you receive in pristine form, and your role is to hold it over time. We believe that legacy is made. It's constantly made and remade.
For some, it's about building up the Mandela brand. This is one of Mandela's grandchildren in 2011, getting her makeup done for a planned reality show on the lives of three of Mandela's granddaughters. The show never really took off, but this was just one initiative launched by Mandela's family while he was alive. Others involved clothing ranges, branded with his prison number or his face. A collection of fine wines called House of Mandela was also sold by Mandela's daughter and granddaughter, who spoke to us after the launch in 2010. They said they knew they'd be criticized for trying to commercialize the Mandela name.
Then the Mandela name has been commercialized already, Robin. I mean, you look at all the people that have used my grandfather's name to benefit themselves. You look at my grandfather's, you know, his face is on a cloth, piece of cloth. His face is on a gold coin, you know. And what we're saying is that that is not the true story and the true reflection of Nelson Mandela.
That's part. No, yeah,
it's a small part. The people that can tell the story, the real story of Nelson Mandela, or not the House of Mandela, is us, his family.
Why can't we use our name in a responsible manner? In a manner that actually honors who we are and how we've come to this place, and say to people, share a bit of this and tell your own story.
In a way, Mandela's story is the story of South Africa, which is why so many people here feel like they'd like to own a little piece of him, even if it is just his face on some tacky memorabilia. Robin Kono, CNN, Johannesburg, South Africa.